Overwatch 2 has a pretty big hero roster. With the release of Venture, there will be exactly 40 heroes to choose from, all with slightly different playstyles, giving the game a fair bit of variety. With this comes heroes that counter each other. It's a commonly known fact that some heroes are just better at killing specific heroes because they have abilities that just practically immobilize them, making them the counterpick. And in this video, I'm gonna tell you how you can counterpick any hero in the game by simply using your initiative. If you learn how to counterpick through initiative, then you'll be able to counterpick anyone in the game, even new and upcoming heroes when they eventually release. But first, I'm going to ask you to subscribe and leave a like on this video, as I want to continue making Overwatch 2 related content that's not only entertaining, but educational too. Now, I'm not going to give you a concise list of which heroes counter which, as that would be too easy. You should be learning from initiative because that's how you get better at the game, through trial and error. This video is here just to give you a bit of guidance so you get an understanding of how to counterpick as a whole, not just in specific scenarios. So, how do you counterpick? Well, it's quite simple actually. Just think about the enemy's strengths and play against them. That's it, that's the whole video. Thanks for watching, have a nice day or night. No, it's actually a little bit more than just thinking about the enemy's strong points and playing against them. Obviously, this is the most important part about counterpicking, but you need to adapt your playstyle to make sure that the enemy that's particularly making your team spend most of the match in spawn doesn't keep doing that. For example, if Roadhog's the problem, don't just swap to Ana and keep hitting him with anti-heal. Do that as well as exploiting the fact that he isn't as strong at a range if he doesn't have hook. This is something you should do with every enemy hero. Think about where they're most effective and take that away from them. If they're a sniper and good at range, then play a dive character that can force them off the high ground or just flat out kill them in close quarters combat. If they're a close quarters hero, play a better close quarters hero or a sniper at an angle where they'll least expect you to be playing at. If they're a tank, play DPS heroes with a high fire rate that can constantly apply the DPS passive to them and in turn kill them a lot faster because they're losing a bit of healing. But that actually does it for this video. It's a very short one, but counterpicking is a staple part of Overwatch because without it, your team are most likely gonna lose since you're letting the enemy team run you down without consequence. Yeah, if you're lucky, you might trade, but in the long run, they'll still win overall. This is why we counterpick. If we remove the problem from the game, then the game gets a lot easier to win. Anyways, thanks for watching. Once again, I'm gonna ask you to like this video as it lets me know that you find these videos not only to be helpful, but entertaining. This was only a short one, but hopefully now you have a slightly better understanding of how to counterpick by using your initiative rather than someone spelling it out for you, allowing you to essentially counterpick the entire hero roster. Finally, have a nice day or night if you're watching this at night, and make sure to check out my other videos. Not only will I appreciate it, but you might too.